Hello everybody and welcome. My name is Paul Pietsch and I'm the product manager for simulated moving bed chromatography at Knauer Wissenschaftliche Geräte GmbH. Knauer is situated in Berlin, Germany, and we are a manufacturer for high-end scientific instruments as HPLC, FPLC, preparative HPLC, GPC, osmometers, and of course, simulated moving bed chromatography. In this video, I will explain the theory of the simulated moving bed process. So let's have a look on the agenda of this short webinar. First, I want to illustrate on an example the step from batch chromatography to continuous chromatography. Second, I'll explain the true moving bed process, and this concept is necessary to understand finally the simulated moving bed process. Let's start with the topic from batch chromatography to continuous countercurrent chromatography. You see a simplified illustration for single column batch chromatography. The stationary phase is considered as the ground, here, for instance, sand. Now let us consider two substances represented by a rabbit and a turtle. The rabbit is a substance with the lower affinity to the stationary phase and the turtle with the higher affinity, represented by their velocities. And these guys are doing a race and they are running to the right side where they fall into a vessel. So the result is quite clear. The rabbit is of course faster than the turtle and is the first one who reaches the right side. This is a simplified illustration for a batch chromatography. The next step is the continuous countercurrent chromatography. We have the same conditions, but the only difference is that the ground is moving through the countercurrent direction. And if the velocity of the ground is smaller than the velocity of the rabbit and the turtle, both rabbit and turtle will be retarded, but the result will be the same as in the previous case. The rabbit reaches the right-hand side before the turtle. Then we can also increase the velocity of the sand so that the sand is moving faster than the rabbit and the turtle. Both animals will reach the left-hand side. The first one will be the turtle, followed by the rabbit. And the third case is that the movement of the sand is faster than the turtle, but slower than the rabbit. And with that result, the animals will be separated. The turtle reaches the left-hand side and the rabbit reaches the right-hand side. And now, if we continuously feed rabbits and turtles to the center of the sand, then both of them can be separated continuously. And this is the principle of the continuous countercurrent chromatography. So let's go forward and have a more scientific view on it. The simulated moving bed chromatography is explained by the theoretical concept of the true moving bed process. In contrast to the classical chromatographical processes, in which only the liquid phase moves, the solid phase moves in countercurrent. The principle of TMB is illustrated in this figure. You see here a standing column, where the solid and liquid phase moves in countercurrent direction. The process room is divided by the two inlet streams, feed and eluent, and by the two outlets, extract and refinate, into four zones. The mobile phase flows from zone 1 towards zone 4, from the bottom to the top, and the solid phase from zone 4 to zone 1. The feed, in this example a mixture of two components A and B, is continuously added between zone 2 and 3. The more adsorbed component A moves with the solid phase downwards and can be removed as extract between zone 1 and 2. In contrast, the weaker adsorbing component B is transported with the mobile phase upwards towards zone 4 and can be removed as refinate between zone 3 and 4. In zone 2 and 3, the separation takes place, and zone 1 and 4 have the function to regenerate the solid and mobile phase. To refer to our previous example, the rabbit represents component B and the turtle component A. A countercurrent stream of solid and mobile phase would lead to abrasion of the solid phase and backmixing. effects. And a technical implementation of the TMB process is hardly possible. And these circumstances led to the development of the SMB process. The first step from TMB to SMB is to split the stationary phase into single columns. For example, here the zones are divided into two segments. And each segment can be transferred into a single chromatography column. And with this knowledge, let's have a look for the SMB process. The SMB is divided as a TMB by the two inlet streams, feed and eluent, and the two outlet streams, extract and raffinate, into four zones. The solid phase consists now of columns connected in series. Usually per zone, one up to four columns are used. In this example, two columns per zone. The implementation of the countercurrent can be achieved, of course, by the movement of the columns, but technically applied as a periodically switching of the in and outlets in the flow direction of the liquid phase. If the inputs and outputs are regarded as reference systems, the columns move against the flow direction by switching the in and outlets. For example, this inlet eluent is switched to the left side to this point, then automatically this column moves here to zone 4. And this causes a simulated movement of the solid phase. The process concept is limited to the separation of binary or pseudo-binary mixtures, since the separation is only possible in the two fractions, raffinate and extract. The advantage of the SMB is the improved utilization of the solid phase, since the separation is possible if the concentration zones of the components to be separated overlap significantly over the column length. Higher productivity with lower eluent consumption is achieved compared to the classical batch chromatography. And to sum up, this is the basic theory of the simulated moving bed process. Thank you for your attention. For more information, please visit our website knauer.net/smb.